in language testing. So I will first introduce myself. So this is Aniket from Remix team. And regarding the in language testing, we basically Remix provide a module for this purpose that is named Remix Tests. So with Remix Tests, you can use the Solidity to write the unit tests for the Solidity contract itself. So basically Remix Tests is a core of Remix IDE Solidity unit testing plugin. So I will quickly demonstrate this plugin and so that we can understand this, it's working. So I'm sharing my screen here. I think I'm visible now. Francie, can you confirm that my screen is shared?
Yes, it is.
Oh, cool. So this Solidity unit testing plugin comes with the Solidity environment. So you can just quickly select this environment and get this double checkbox here in the side panel. So this is the Solidity unit testing plugin. So as it says, you can test your smart contract in Solidity. And to get started, you should just select a file, a Solidity file from the file explorer and click on the generate to generate a test file. So let's quickly demo it. So I am selecting a very basic storage.sol file. And so now you will see that this generate button is now enabled. So it also says generate sample test file. Now if I will click on this, so a new test file will be generated in the same folder where the file to be tested is. And I will quickly talk about this file. So you will see that we are importing this remix underscore tests.sol. And here in the comments, it is mentioned very well. I would like to zoom that this import is automatically injected by Remix. So this is the library which is responsible to perform the assert actions, which are used below in this file. So with Remix tests, your test file should have this suffix, that underscore test.sol, using which we detect that this is a test file. And also, yes, like an usual Solidity file, this file can also contain more than one test suite. So like a testing framework, Remix tests also provide some special functions that are before each, before all, after each, and after all. So as their names are, before each, the any code inside before each will be executed before each, before running each test. And any code inside before all function will be running before all the tests, and similar for the after each and after all. So there are some initial tests here. So we use this assert library here. And regarding this assert library, if you want to see that what all things are available with this library, you can go to the documentation here, and there is one dedicated section for this assert library. So we have these methods available currently. And then here are some methods to run the tests. So there are basic, there are very basic ones. So we are just comparing the integers with them and using more methods. And there is another way, if you are not looking to use any assert library, so you can also use this returns property, in which you can use the return value to test the contract. And then at the end, there is one failure test. So if I will quickly run this file, so here there will be all a tests file loaded here. You can select a file here to run the test, and I will quickly run it here. So this progress bar shows the progress of the file tests, and here you will see the results of it. For a passing test, it will be in the green, and for the failing ones, it will be in red, and also will be showing the reasons of failure, which you will mention here in this equal test. And this test overall will show a fail if at least one contact test for this file is failed. So at here you can see the total time that was consumed to run these tests. So I would like to also explain this before each and before all functions functionality. So this can be understood using this existing ballot test file. So we have this ballot contract. I think people using the Solidity should be very familiar to it. So regarding that, we have tests in this file. So you can use this before all to create an instance of a ballot contract in before running any test. So you can just create an array of names, and you can instantiate that ballot contract here, and then you can further use that that instance to run multiple tests on the methods. Okay, so I will quickly also like to summarize that if you want to provide the compiler configuration for running this test file, so we use the Solidity compiler plugin for that. So while then compiling this test file, we will pick the compiler version from this tab, and this EVM version from here, and also you can enable or disable optimization here for the long contract. And for the custom transaction context, if we talk about that, we can configure the transaction for a custom message of sender or message of value. So we basically provide that inbuilt functionality here. I would like to quickly run a test here. So we use a Solidity NAT spec for that. So there is a fixed syntax for that. So you can just mention this sender with a hash and a colon and a space like this in your just before a method in which you want to set the sender. So to use this account functionality, you need to import one more file, that is remix accounts.sort. So this account, this library provides the accounts to set as a sender, and there are currently 10 accounts available. So they move from 0 to 9. So you can provide the index 0 to 9 here. And if I can quickly check it here, so you can, we can directly check the message of sender here, and the method to access these accounts is this. So we can use here wallet sender check system config. Okay, so I can remove these things from here. And now if we will run this contract again, okay, semicolon is missing. So this will be passing. This is our check custom config. So this ensures that the message.sender, which is getting passed inside this method, is the account 9. So this can be used in many contexts. Another custom configuration which remix tests provide is for the value, which is very useful in the payable methods. So you can define a value using the similar syntax here. So this is a value in V, which will be passed in this along with this method execution. So I can just quickly write one more test here. Okay.
Anika, just looking at timing, it would be good if we could wrap it up soon.
Yeah.
Because we have other tests in the pipeline.
Yeah, we are done in just 1 minute. So this is the another way of message.value. So we can provide the custom transaction configuration that like that. And remix tests can also be used as a CLI and CI module. So that is well explained in the documentation part.